Hello, Patricia here, licensed esthetician and member of the Scientific Advisory Board at Kyani. Welcome to today's next topic, where we're talking about why we lose our glow of our skin. And yes, I'm talking about the skin because in literally the glow that we have when we see a youthful person walk in the room and like their skin's radiating. But we know over time we lose that glow. And I'm here to talk about why and how we can help slow the process of losing our glow and actually kind of gain it back. So we're talking about aging, of course, and there's two strong factors that are going to be influencing the aging of not only our skin, but also our body. And when we talk about skin, a lot of the things we're talking about, because I loved having that inside out, outside in approach, are going to be influenced by what we're doing on the inside. So the skin is just kind of, again, that organ that shows us what's going on. So two factors that are going to be affecting that are our inevitable aging and our accelerated aging, and what we can do to help these two areas. So let's go into the inevitable agers. We know this is just the natural wear and tear that we have on our body. It's like living in a home. Once in a while, we're gonna bang into a wall. We're gonna have some paint chipping off. Some of these things are just kind of inevitable things that happen as we live and breathe every single day. But the result is we're having a slowing of not only our mind, our muscles, our metabolism, joints, eyesight, skin health, is pretty much all of our body systems. Think of these as those inevitable agers. But we don't have to feel helpless, so stay with me here. Let's go into our accelerated agers. Accelerated agers are also things that we are going to be exposed to, but we have a lot more control, if you will, of how much these are going to impact us or not. I'm going to start with the top one here. You can see the huge pile of sugar cubes back here. Foods with added sugar. If you're not a label reader yet, I highly encourage you to become a label reader. Even if you have to put your readers on in the middle of the grocery store, you really need to know what's in the foods. So according to Robert Lustig, he's a professor of pediatrics in the Division of Endocrinology at the University of California, San Francisco, and he's basically considered the leading authority on the dangers of sugar. He states that the body can safely metabolize only up to 6 teaspoons of added sugar per day. That is not very much, folks. And so if you're not reading labels and they're sneaking this 12 grams in, or like this little can of Squirt soda had 24 grams of added sugar, I mean, you're surpassing your daily allowance 4 times over. I mean, it's really mind-boggling. The average American consumes 19.5 teaspoons a day. That's 82 grams of sugar. And just so think of when you're having that, I'm just fading out my glow. I'm aging myself faster. And it's not that we can't have sugar. We can have it up to certain amounts, but you might want to have like, maybe set like parameters of, you know what, I'm going to have sweets 1 day a week, or I'm going to have maybe bread 1 day a week because I'm needing to keep my carbs and my simple sugars and my added sugars out. If you're making homemade bread, whole grain, great. But if you look at the ones in the store, a lot of them have added sugar. And why? It's because they think we want it. And when people actually keep buying it every day, they're going to keep selling it like that every day until we create the change as the consumer. I get on my soapbox here, so I digress, because we're talking about losing the glow of our skin, but this just cascades over into other health issues. I just could go on all day. And Dr. Andreas, my husband, you hear him talking about these things all the time, but focusing on our skin, we want to keep our sugars down, okay? And this is number one on the list of accelerated agers. And we wonder why we have such chronic disease crisis, especially in the United States. Although I know other countries have some challenges with that too. We're just really up there, and I'm not very proud of that. Added sugar increases the body's demand for insulin. And insulin is that hormone that gets secreted when we have carbohydrates. And you've probably seen Dr. Andreas talk a lot about the body's response to insulin, so I'll kind of stop here, but just know sugar is triggering a hormone to be released. Insulin is that hormone that helps convert food into energy, but we get insulin sensitive as we have too much sugar because we're having to pump out so much insulin that's a resistant. So, well, that's basically, it's excess insulin stresses our system. That's what we need to remember, causing many types of cellular dysfunction, diabetes, heart issues, high blood pressure. Added sugar also causes more AGEs, which are those advanced glycation end products that we've talked about in the past, basically age accelerators. which cause premature skin wrinkling and cell structure hardening. So this all ties back into the aging and the glowing of our skin, amongst all the other havoc that it's wrecking throughout our system. More accelerated agers, environmental toxins. Now we know these come in different forms. We're going to talk about pollution. Also, cigarette and other voluntary sources of smoke. This includes the vaping. This includes not inhaling even cigars and things. Your mouth is highly absorbent. So these toxins are getting in these different ways and just living and breathing every day with the pollution we have, right? And then excessive UV exposure. This is a big one, and this one is definitely one that's an accelerated ager. However, we have a lot of control over this one, a lot more than we think. It's basically breaking down the skin from the outside in by causing a visible burn. In addition, it damages related cells and structures, leading to a toxic cellular environment, which may lead to the development of skin cancer. One in every three cancers diagnosed in the United States is actually skin cancer, and that's a frightening statistic. Also promoting premature damage to internal structures of the skin, including our natural collagen, which we know is the building blocks that support and keep our skin nice and plump and dense. The elastin, which is what keeps it bouncy like the rubber band, this invisible kind of woven basket under the skin is the collagen and the elastin. Then hydrating lipids and hyaluronic. Lipids are the oils in our skin. Hyaluronic is the water-loving part of our skin. All of these make up the structure of our skin, and excessive UV exposure is breaking down and unweaving that basket. It's kind of like, if you don't go out with some sunblock on, you're going to be out for maybe even 15, you know, extra minute or more than 15 minutes or so. Just know you're going to be degrading the skin down. We have clothing with UVA, UVB protection in it now, hats that have that in there, and then we have our zinc oxide sunblocks, which is the natural way to protect our skin and reflect the rays away. Nothing is 100%, except of course being indoors without exposure to light, but we know we need the sun, so just make sure we keep that excessive exposure down to keep that glow and keep our skin healthier. Another accelerated ager is sedentary life. You've heard the expression, sitting is the new smoking. It is absolutely true. It's kind of like if you are sitting around all day and you expect to have an abundance of energy. We've all had those days where we're kind of like, eh, and we're not doing as much potentially. And though we need our rest days, I kind of find that I have less energy on those days. And the busier I kind of am, the more productive I am and the more energy I have. And it's kind of like the analogy I kind of think of with when you charge a phone or you charge anything that has a charging system, and it's the battery's never kind of going down. They say over time that battery is losing its strength. So movement, you know, Andreas and I talk about movement meditation, keep moving, try not to lead a sedentary life. It's going to accelerate your aging. Individuals who are strongly or who are physically active during their leisure time appear to be biologically younger than those with sedentary lifestyles, according to a new report. So again, keep it moving. When we are not moving and growing, we are in decay. So stay young, stay moving. Number four, lack of sleep. According to the Sleep Health Foundation, nearly half of us aren't getting enough sleep. Nearly half of us. That's a huge number. I know the old adage, as we get older, we don't need as much sleep. Maybe that's true. I think it's probably an individual thing, but whenever we feel like we're run down, we are probably run down, and half of us are not getting our proper rest, with women having an even harder time falling asleep. And I can't explain that one for everyone, but I can tell you that my mind goes a million miles into the future, and when things are on it, it is hard to fall asleep. So we'll talk about ways in which we can help with this particular accelerated ager. Growth and renewal happen during sleep. Very, very important. And vital cell regeneration happens within our skin. So this is why we do our retinols at night. This is why we do our alpha hydroxys topically at night, because we want those cells to be regenerating, repairing, turning over, getting rid of the damaged skin, revealing new healthy skin from underneath. So my theory has always been cleanse, use your antioxidants during the day, hydrate and protect, and at night it's going to be also some hydration, but definitely the repairing component that the alpha hydroxys and retinols and cellular turnover promote. And a recent study suggests that even one night's sleep deprivation causes cells to age faster. Even one night. And you know, if we've all had those nights where we're staying up later, where maybe had an event or something, We can feel the difference the next day, and the older we get, the more we seem to feel that. Whether it's a glass of wine or two glasses of wine, it seems like once we pass a certain age, we feel it, whereas before maybe we didn't. So there are different things happening with our body, and we have to be aware of that because our skin is going to start showing that toll. The results of the study showed that sleeping for less than recommended amount of time promoted biological aging in older adults. So this is really important to get your adequate sleep every night. And the good news in all of this is that we can influence the 70% of our age-related symptoms and problems. That's huge, 70%. So what can we do? I'm suggesting a focused approach. Healthy dietary choices, proper supplementation, regular balanced exercise, proper sleep, stress management, and consistent use of high quality skincare and skin protection in the form of topical skincare with the zinc oxide, antioxidants, making sure you're getting proper cleansing, exfoliation, all of the above. With these, and also using great skincare, these tips can help us maybe slow down some of that aging and hold on to that glow a little bit longer. And we'll be talking in more videos, and as I have in the past, of what we actually have to do topically to keep our skin glowing as well. But I hope this gives you a really good starting point. As always, I love doing these videos. I enjoy your comments below. Please post any questions you may have and get with the person that sent you this video. Thank them and please share. And I look forward to seeing you all next time.